Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, salawatullahu wa salamuhu alayh, was born on the 13th of Rajab in the year 600 and died on the 21st of Ramadan in the 40th year after Hijrah. He occupies a prominent position within the religion of Islam as being revered as one of the greatest leaders in Islamic history. A man from whose life many extraordinary lessons may be learnt and many examples may be derived. And a man who was seen as the embodiment of knowledge, generosity, valor and bravery, as well as dedication towards the religion of Islam. An honor in Islamic history only reserved for Ali ibn Abi Talib. That he is the only man in Islamic history to be born in the Kaaba. You will find that there are some other historical references to other people being born in the Kaaba. But this was a group of people who tried to diminish from the prestige of Ali ibn Abi Talib. The only man in history to be born in the Kaaba, to be born in that black cube that you find in Mecca, was Ali. And that's why you find when his mother emerged from the Kaaba on the fourth day, the first person to welcome her was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet welcomed her, he took Ali from her hands, and the Imam himself would narrate that from that day, throughout his childhood, the Prophet would embrace Ali.
Ali, 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 Ali.
Ali is the gem that is unlike any other. Amir al-Mu'mineen. وسيد الوصيين وإمام المتقين ويعسوب المسلمين أمير المؤمنين أسد الله الغالب علي بن أبي طالب is a truly unique character because he's the only person in history who's been able to combine and bring together all these antithetical qualities in the same human being. He is the one who is seen weeping and sobbing and crying in the middle of the night, calling out, Mawlaya, Mawlaya, Anta al-Sayyidu wa ana al-Abd, wa hal yarham al-Abdu illa al-Sayyid. In the famous supplication of Amir al-Mu'mineen, read it, brothers and sisters. Read this supplication. You'll be reminded of just how great a personality Ali ibn Abi Talib was. These words are originating from the mouth of a man who is the bravest on the battlefield, who is the most ferocious in the face of the enemies of God, who is the greatest commander of any army. This is the same man who smashed open the gate of Khaybar single-handedly. Ali ibn Abi Talib is the one who does not tolerate oppression. Ali ibn Abi Talib, who is so sensitive about the way the treasury is handled. Not a single dime is taken from it unjustly under his watchful eyes. We could go on and on for years, and by God we'll never be able to do justice to the justice of Ali. Why is Ali ibn Abi Talib so special? Because he was the first to submit to the religion of Allah. Ali ibn Abi Talib was the first to come to Rasulullah whenever he needed help. He was always the first to respond to Rasulullah. Amir al-Mu'mineen was always the first to stand in the battlefield while everyone fled for their lives. Ali ibn Abi Talib is this great man whose name we will call for our entire lives. When you want to get up, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to sit down, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to climb a bunch of stairs, you say, Ya Ali. When you want to help your kids ride a bicycle, you teach them to say, Ya Ali. When your mother's giving birth to you at the hospital, she calls out, Ya Ali. Why? Because Rasulullah always called out, Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Ya Ali.
Ya Ali. Ya Ali. Ya Ali. علي ينمو الظهر العجائب تجده عونا لك في النوائب نادي علي ينمو الظهر العجائب تجده عونا لولايتك يا علي يا علي كل هم وغم سينجلي بولايتك يا علي يا علي
مولاي يا أنت المولى وأنا العبد وهل يرحم العبد إلا المولى.
Not only is the one who is the bravest on the battlefield, he is the one who is the lion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one who will stand one-on-one against any single oppressor. He is the one who will stand one against any number of thousands of the oppressors. He is the father of Sayyid al-Shuhada. He is the one who smashed open the gates of Khaybar with just one hand. Yet, in these verses, he is able to humble himself to such a way where he will sit in front of his Lord and say, I am nothing. Who else can be merciful to me except you? I may be the one who is deemed as having such strength, but here I am the weakest of all human beings. I rely upon your strength at this time. And therefore in this du'a we wish to inculcate what is being said in these particular words. When you recite this du'a, manifest it in your heart. Live through each and every word. Bring tears to the eyes. Bring presence of heart to the mind. And then you will flow.
يا علي
الدمع دم
يا علي
يا علي
علي
علي يا صاحب النجوى.
One of the things that comes out clearly about the life and character of the young man Ali during the Prophet's own lifetime is that he was somebody of remarkable wisdom, that people would come to him to ask his advice, to seek his counsel. But he was also someone of remarkable courage, and so we read again and again of him being sent to lead a group of men who were to go out to defend the community of Medina. And we read of him again and again being sent into single combat. Now, any of us, no matter what kind of a warrior we are and how skilled we are, we know that when it comes to one-to-one combat, you have got a 50-50 chance that you're not going to go home from this. To do it once is one thing, to do it a few times, but to do it repeatedly is a sign of great courage, of great character, and of great leadership. But then secondly, let's put that alongside another example of the leadership of Imam Ali. And that is, after the Prophet's death, when the group of elders get together and they decide that they're going to take things in their own direction, it would have been then an easy thing for Ali to stand and shout and to call an uprising, as it were. And instead, he takes a position of dignity. He says, I'm not a rabble leader. I am the one chosen by God to lead this community. It is God's business to see that I am brought into my rightful position. And so one of the qualities of leadership is that you don't stamp and shout and tell everybody how wonderful you are, but you allow your natural character and also your God-given position to shine through so that eventually people will recognize you.
يا علي بايعناك نحيا ونموت وياك
حبك ربينا وانت ولينا شيعتك بايعنا نحيا ونموت وياك حبك ربينا وانت ولينا يا علي يا علي وانت ولينا.
There's a remarkable story that's told about Imam Ali in single-handed combat, and others from the community are standing around watching, and the fight goes one way and then goes the other, and eventually Imam Ali has the man on the ground and is about to deliver the final blow and kill him. And in that instant, the man on the ground spits in Ali's face. And Ali puts up his sword and walks away. And the people say to him, "Why did you do that? You had him beaten. You had him on the floor. Just one stroke and you would have killed him." And Imam Ali turned and said, "If I had done that before he had spat in my face, it would have been an act of justice. But if I had done that after he spat in my face, it would have been an act of revenge, an act of anger and of vengeance, not an act of justice at all. And so I turned away and did not kill him." One of the things that we have to remember is that the person of strength who acts with justice, even if it goes against themselves, is a person that we can admire. Whereas the person who abuses justice is the person who is a corrupt leader. And so we see in this little instant from the life of Imam Ali the true quality of what a just leader should be like. The humanity of human beings is something that is not affected by their wealth, by their status, by their poverty, by their lowly demeanor. Every human being is of infinite value. We have a famous saying from Imam Ali that every human being is either already your brother in faith or your brother in humanity. And therefore every human being is to be valued and respected. In an age in which leaders think that they should be waited on, think that they should have fine robes, and everyone should regard them as a person of great dignity, we have the example of Imam Ali, who goes to feed the poor himself during the time of his own leadership. So he gives us an example of leadership. True leadership does not stand on its dignity, but rather it stands alongside the poor and respects them in their time of need. Part of the time of need of a poor person is that it can come at a time that is not very convenient. We have the famous example of the poor person seeking alms, who goes to different people in the mosque but is turned away because they are too busy. They're in their prayers. And it is, of course, that famous example when Imam Ali uniquely gives his ring in charity when he is at his prayers, when he is bending in ruku'. And so he is a reminder to us that the call of the poor is always there, and we must always be ready to respond to it.
In history, there is only one man in history that gave zakat in the state of ruku, and that is Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salatu wassalam. His status is so elevated that he has enraged the enemies. His wisdom was beyond comprehension. When you ask me such question, when he says, "Saluni, saluni, qabla an tafqiduni," ask me before you miss me. Why did he say that? Because he has already been endowed with this wisdom. He has been endowed with this knowledge for you and I to follow. He's just not a man of wisdom. He's a man of action. You and I, brothers and sisters, should be Muslims of action. The Imam, the name of Ali ibn Abi Talib, is Sha'air Allah, is Dhikr. Dhikrullah. To mention the name of Imam Ali is Dhikr of Allah, because when you look at him, he does nothing but takes you to Allah. He never takes you to himself. He never says, worship me. He never says, how great I am. He never does any of that. He keeps taking us to the Prophet and Allah. Keeps taking us to the Prophet and Allah. So why should he not be remembered? Why should we not remember him? Why should we not mention him? Why should we not live like
him? يومين أزورك بالنجف راويني قبري أقسم عليك بدمعتي علي يا علي بيتك وعايف رجعتي علي يا علي.